Although Maria Falconetti is only really known for one film, The Passion of Joan of Arc by Carl Theodor Dreyer in 1928, it's a performance that's gone down as one of the most intense and richly emotional in all of cinema history. As Roger Ebert said in 1997, you cannot know the history of the silent film without knowing the face of Renee Maria Falconetti. But out of all the performances in silent cinema, why is this one regarded as so powerful? The answer lies in the close-up. Hello and welcome to 100 Years of Cinema. We'll be taking a look at least one film each year from 1915 onwards to track the evolution of film over the last century. The Passion of Joan of Arc takes real testimony from the actual historical trial to tell the story of Joan's last days, and although Dreyer had large, expensive sets built for the film, it doesn't contain a single establishing shot. In fact, the film is told almost exclusively through close-up. Think about the variety of shots that are used in a modern film. An establishing shot shows us where the characters are in the world. Two shots let us know where the characters are in relation to each other. Wides, mid-shots, panning and editing all help establish the geography of a scene. But instead of this, Dreyer chooses to frame tight around the characters' faces in almost every shot. Very few shots contain more than one person, and there's almost no camera movement. This makes it really difficult for the audience to place where the characters are within the scene. What's also strange is that the film lacks any kind of exposition. Although the audience might be aware of the true history of Joan of Arc, the film itself tells us nothing about her life and doesn't even really tell us why she's on trial, because ultimately these details are unimportant. Because this film is less about characters as they move through space or the events that unfold around them, and more about the characters themselves. Dreyer pulls in close to represent the scrutiny that Joan is placed under by her jury, but just as the Inquisitors have Joan under a lens, so do we as the audience. This is a film about oppression, belief, martyrdom, religious experience, fear, and conspiracy. It's an intimate exploration of emotion, and it explores through one of cinema's most expressive tools, the close-up. In an article called Catching Characters' Emotions, Emotional Contagion Responses to Narrative Fiction Film, Assistant Professor of Philosophy at California State University, Amy Copeland, talks about the close-up and its almost unique ability to affect an audience through emotional contagion. The tendency to automatically mimic and synchronize expressions, vocalizations, postures and movements with those of another person, and consequently to converge emotionally. Basically, when you see someone expressing emotion, your body automatically, involuntarily, and unconsciously mimics that expression, and that physical mimicry can affect how you feel emotionally. Copeland points to the opening scenes of Saving Private Ryan. Before the soldiers storm the beach, there are 8 close-ups of different men. Some are praying, some stand in anticipation or fear. Our investment in the rest of the scene lies in our immediate and primal emotional reaction to these close-ups. When most people think about the storming of Omaha Beach, it's an event so far removed from our everyday life that it's hard to think of the people involved as real. Through close-up, Spielberg puts us in the shoes of these men and allows us to take a human perspective on a historical battle. This is what happens when you combine a great director with a great performance. A single moment of emotional convergence between a character and the audience can change the meaning of a whole scene, colouring the experience and giving the audience a new perspective on events. Take a look at this scene from The Godfather. Coppola starts with an over-the-shoulder shot, and then slowly pushes in until he's tight around Michael's face. Look at these two shots side by side. Which has the most emotional impact? If you remove the close-up of Michael, the plot still hangs together, but by showing the uncertainty on Michael's face, Coppola reveals an extra dimension of the story, of a man deciding between sticking to his morals as the honourable son of a crime lord, or committing a murder and taking his father's place. The same is true for the 1957 film 12 Angry Men. If you remove the close-ups from the film and shot everything in a wide, the plot would still operate the same. But by getting close to the actors' faces, the audience are taken on the same journey as the characters as they slowly change their mind and decide to spare a man's life, moving from boredom, apathy and hatred to forgiveness and understanding. The amount of empathy you experience from the close-ups of the jurors is why the film is still so effective more than 50 years later. And even though the film only takes place in one room, close-ups allow you to experience an entire world of emotion. The close-up is the cinematic equivalent of a playwright's soliloquy. It tells you more than just what the character's feeling, it can change the way that you feel. It's what makes great cinema such an intimate experience, by letting you live someone else's point of view. And that's exactly what Maria Falconetti and Carl Dreyer managed to do in The Passion of Joan of Arc. They took historical documents from a real trial and gave you the subjective view of a young girl being scrutinised and tortured for her beliefs. Falconetti's performance lays bare the depth of human emotion, so the final scenes of the film where Joan is burned to the stake are made all the more powerful because we know what she went through and we've seen the world through her eyes. The close-up can be used to show more than the actual shot itself, so if you're a filmmaker and you want to show the true scope of the world, maybe you'll reveal more with a close-up than a wide.
Thanks for watching 100 Years of Cinema. My name's Charlie. First of all, I want to say a massive thank you to my latest Patreons. That's Jimmy, Andres Estevira, and Jacob Caswell. Your support really does mean a lot, so thank you so much. If you'd also like to help me make more videos like this, there's a link to my Patreon in the information box below, and by choosing to support, you'll help me invest in new audio equipment, which will really help boost the quality of the show. The Passion of Joan of Arc is an amazing film, and it's available to watch for free on YouTube, but if you want to watch the highest quality version with an amazing soundtrack, I recommend picking up the Criterion DVD, and I've provided links to both of those in the information box below. As always, please like, comment and share this video, and let me know what you think is the most emotional close-up in all of cinema in the comments below. Thanks for watching.